Hey, what's up, guys? Just kind of organizing everything before we get started. As the title states, we're going to be attempting to answer some questions while I cut some coral. The only thing is I usually have my iPad here, or Android pad or whatever, so I can see the questions, but I'm actually going to have to focus on the screen over here and see if I can get it. So, yep, this is situated. Should probably plug my phone in. There you go. Alrighty. So yeah, so if you guys are not aware of this, I posted some stuff today. I do have a sale going on, and it's like 50% off, and a lot of corals are like 10 bucks. So you can check that out if you want. But yeah, so I got a whole bunch of colonies I got to cut up, so we're gonna do that. This is the Poseidon Tort. Remember, I took that out of the 300 a little while ago. We're gonna cut up most of this and then put a little bit of it back. But yeah, that's the Poseidon Tort. So we're gonna do a little bit with the bone cutters first. Do what we can with the bone cutters and then come in with a saw, but pretty simple process here. So how's everybody doing? I wanted to get a video out today, but we had too many orders going on. Let me turn the music down a little bit. But yeah, we had a bunch of orders go out, so I wasn't able to make that video I wanted to, but I will do it tomorrow. So yeah. So I'm not sure if the questions are gonna pop up on the screen. They do, but yeah, they don't stay very long. So I'm gonna have to see if anything pops up on the other screen. But yeah, so just kind of chilling tonight, relaxing after a long day. Hot as nuts outside. I went to the range. Actually, I was shooting 96 yards. And I missed, of course. And shot a little too high because I ranged it wrong. And I ended up putting one of my arrows through a 2x4. So the arrow went completely through the 2x4, stuck out the other side. The whole arrow had to get snapped in half, but had some serious force with that bow. So we'll just kind of get off what we can here. So I like to come in here with the bone cutters first, just so I'm not, yeah, see, I broke some off, messing with the saw too much and cutting off too big of a chunk that I don't really want.
Hey, what's up?
If you guys notice, I took the cut to order off the website, mainly because it's more of a pain in the butt than it's worth. So what I'm doing now is I'm just cutting frags from the tank every single week, because like I said, we're in the process of kind of getting ready to relocate, the hopes. So I'm just cutting corals every single week from the system, so if it doesn't look like it's growing, that's why. just kidding. No, I just suck at growing coral. But so the cut-to-order stuff isn't really going to be an option anymore. I'm just going to have stuff available when it's available. Because we got to the point where we had so many cut-to-order orders that I had no place to put them, and it was a little bit of a headache. There we go. Again, if you guys are wondering, this is the Poseidon Tort. I wonder if I can see questions if I click. No, that doesn't work. Let me look over here and see what we got. Anything good? Yeah, I don't want to turn it vertical because then it looks dumb. So this is fine. Come on, son of a bitch. We got here. It's gotta be an easier way though. Actually, I think I can click right here. Oh, there we go. All messes are visible. There we go. So I just gotta scroll up. There we go. Travis, what do you think of the Chato reactors? Well, they work. Maintenance is a little bit on them, but they do work. Will I use one again? Probably not. I'm more of an old school Refugium guy. And I enjoy the Refugium. So if I just click this button, it brings up all the... Hey Travis, what makes Zoa's start to melt away, start, get smaller, and keep water parameters in check? Well, usually a pest, or if they're getting blasted with flow, usually causes the Zoa's to close up on you, wilt away, too much light. Usually if there's not enough light with Zoa's, they'll start reaching. So it's usually too much light or a pest. But if your water parameters are good, so that's what I would check first. Like I mentioned in the live stream the other day, the best thing you want to do is, if you want to look for anything in your reef tank, is to do it at night. Because that's when all the critters come out to play. All right, so we're going to frag these guys up. We're going to put this back in the tank real quick since it's been out for a little bit. And we'll get to fragging and pull up the questions here. How do you get awesome colors from your Walt Disney's? My parameters are 8.3 DKH, NO3, 2 ppm, PO4, 0.03. And I use the XR15 Gen 4 5 or Gen 5 blue with Reef Bright. You could be, I don't say supplements or anything like that, but you might be lacking something in your tank. So do an ICP test to see what you're missing. If everything checks out, usually par, not enough light, too much light. Or you're missing something in your water column. So do an ICP test and see what else you got going on down there. That's what I would do. Move you all around here. So we'll check out. Let's scroll back up here. Do you like the Griffin saw, band saw? I just bought one. Yeah, it's not bad. It works. I don't use it too often. I'm setting up a separate frag tank. Should I add fish or not? Trying to avoid fishless, fishies, but getting dinos from low nutrients. Yeah, you should have fish in your frag tank. I don't know how big your frag tank is, but if you're big enough to support tangs, those are always good for frag tanks because they do a good job of keeping the tank in check, keeping it clean. Sometimes. Depends on the tang itself. Sometimes they don't. They get spoiled with food and they don't want to pick at anything. So. Check the comments, see if anything comes up. Hi, I added some live, I added some white rock today to my new setup tank. The water went from murky after this and spiked to calcium. I don't know why it would spike to calcium. What kind of rock was it? You said white rock. Like the Texas Holy Rock, I heard that stuff increases pH, but it wouldn't do it in one day. So I think that might be a fluke. I need a little bit more information on the rock. You said white rock, so I'm trying to get these on here real quick. Been out of the water for a few minutes. So I don't know how long I'm going to have that sale on for there because I'm actually, you know, $10 frags is not something I do quite often. But right now I have all these low boys packed. So it's my making room sale because that's literally what I'm doing with it is making room while I cut up more frags. So trying to get rid of some stuff that I have a lot of. And just trying to make room, essentially. Because I am limited on it. I'm not adding any more tanks down here. It's not, no, not in the works. So I can't wait for the new setup, then I can finally have all that amazing room. So what else we got coming in here. Only thing a little low on ICP test was iodine, wanted to see me to dose more. And yeah, then you can start dosing iodine. A lot of coloration has to do with par as well. I've tried out many different, the same coral, many different spots in the tank. I've done it with the green slimer. I've done it with the Cali Tort and, same water parameter, same everything. But the only thing that was different was the par that it was getting. So 200 to 300 difference in par can make a pretty big difference on the coloration of the coral. So keep that in mind. I'm going to go ahead and get these guys over to the tank. This will have to talk amongst yourselves. Is the music too loud? Lots of Poseidon Tort. All right, let me check this. All right, I'm going to go put these in the tank. I'll be right back. Grab these guys. We have a few left. Sorry, this isn't as entertaining as the turn this up. As the Q&A's, but I figured I could show you guys what's going on. Felt bad I didn't get a video out today. I tried to shoot one for Monday, so I spent the weekend getting the voiceover done, the outline-ish. Outline, the voiceover, and just kind of getting things together in the video, but I needed to do some final editing today, and it just didn't happen, so felt bad, so I figured I'd do in live stream. The lazy man's content, and I am lazy. So this holder here, I had a BRS change their top size. So the new version is the V2, which allows us to fit in there. So this is the older version, kind of fits, but the newer one allows it to go back down. So. Someone's like, yeah, it doesn't fit. I'm like, really? So then I ordered another bottle of glue, and I was like, oh, okay. They changed it. Speaking of ordering stuff, that all those bottles will be here tomorrow. Can't wait to mess with those. I asked that wholesaler, the one that, that had that ridiculous price for shipping, I was like, how much do I have to buy from you to get free shipping? They're like, yeah, we don't offer free shipping. I'm like, so if I buy $1,000 worth of bottles right now, you're not going to give me free shipping? They're like, no, we're sorry. I'm like, well, that's ridiculous. My other wholesaler gave me free shipping after $200. So it's crazy. All right, so that's the majority of the Poseidon Tort. Let me see if I can get some more off of it. Nothing really with the bone cutters, so I guess we can come over here with a saw, hack at it for a little bit. Pretty loud. Couple more in here I can get out. And what I'll do is I'll throw this back in this tank and let it heal up and grow a little bit more and do the same thing in another month. Alright. Throw this back in there. Yeah, it's full of test kits. I moved a whole bunch of them out of the way. One thing about life in general is you get, the bigger place you get, just the more things you keep. and the more things that just take up space, and then eventually you run out of room, and then you're looking for more more room. And that's what's going on down here. That is my dipping tank. I haven't used that in forever. For when I was importing coral. So, how many of you guys actually, how many of you guys feel comfortable purchasing coral during the summertime? I've always wondered, because I've never done it. I just, not personally. I bought wholesale stuff during the summertime, but I never personally went out and bought coral. Wonder how many of you guys are interested in or feel comfortable doing that. So, yeah. Do you typically lose coral frags after cutting colonies like that? No, I don't really lose any frags. I used to back in the day, but nope. I don't really lose any. The only time I ever lost anything, like when I was cutting colonies, was if it was imported. So if it was something like, if say I got an Acropora in from Indo or whatever, and I cut that just like that, I'd probably lose 30% just because it's not used to it. It's not used to the environment. But this stuff is fine. I mean, this would just take longer to heal. But it's good to go. I don't really lose anything. Unless my powerheads go crazy and start flinging frags around and they're touching each other. That's a little nub. Yeah. All right, so I'm going to get these guys over there. Now, I'm a little bit of a dilemma here. I have two giant colonies of green digitata that I got to cut up, but I don't know if I can even... I'll start giving that shit away soon. It grows so fast. I think that's pretty much all I can hold here. All right, I will be back in a second. So I got the smaller digitata. I think we'll cut that up. It's just to get it out of the way. But the other one's got to stay. Spill your drink. Bouncing gets up spill quicker, and each sheet is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less than leading value drink. Bouncing, the quicker pick. And we'll do a little bit more of the bird's nest. I think I'll go straight to the saw for the digi. Like these, let me pull up the questions here, see if we got anything come in. Yeah, sorry, I got it. Next time I will, I'll have to, my laptop, it ran out of battery, so it's trying to charge, but it's just not charging. So let's see what we got here. Do you carbon dose? I do not carbon dose. Pretty cool to see that spraying acceleration on the corals after gluing. Then the frag place has no ill effect. Yeah, it doesn't do anything. It doesn't even piss off the skimmer. Yeah. Man, wish I had my, really wish my iPad was working, but it is what it is. All right, so we're gonna cut this digi up. up for that. We'll come back and get the green bird's nest in here in a second. Let's see here. Hey Travis, how is the Trident working for you? It's doing pretty good. Today, for some reason, I got the warning saying it wasn't taking any tests for the last couple days. So I just manually did it and then made sure it was on automatic and it seems to be fine. But for some reason, it just stopped taking tests. So I was like, all right, well, we'll see where this goes. But it seems to be all right now. Water parameters are rock solid now. I got my magnesium back where it needs to be, finally. It's at 1340 somewhere. I got some magnesium coming in the mail. It'll be here tomorrow. So I will bring it up a little bit more. But I was running into all sorts of issues. I'm pretty sure I mentioned this before. I don't know. I talked to so many people that I forget what the heck I'm saying. But what happened is I'm using the new media for the calcium reactor because the reborn ran out. So I ended up using this media that supposedly has high magnesium in it, that ARM, I believe it is, extra coarse. And anyway, I've been using that, and it just hasn't increased the magnesium level in the tank. I usually top off with the Rheomag, but I didn't do it because I thought it already had the magnesium in the media, but unfortunately, it did not. So, yeah, that dropped down, and finally got the levels back to normal, and the tank is happier. So. I do want to get some more fish for my frag tanks. A couple more tanks, because the ones I have are a bunch of bums. They don't do anything. Just nothing. 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 And I'm playing with my nutrients right now, so I wouldn't say algae on the plugs. I got a little dusting, and it'd be nice if they did something other than sit there. But it's nothing crazy. But yeah, I'm trying out some new stuff, and kind of, you know, the point of having a reef tank is trying new things, and that's what I'm doing. I like this song. There we go. Yeah, definitely not monetizing this video. Well, there might be ads because of all the music playing in the background. So every time a song comes up, it gets, I wouldn't say flagged, but it gets, YouTube says, well, what's going on here? And then they notify the person who owns the song. So if we're here for an hour and like 20 or 30 songs go through, I get slammed by each one of those, and then they put ads on the video. So if there's ads, they're not mine. I told you guys I was gonna take the ads off the live streams just because they get pretty ridiculous. So when I am being good and I am able to monetize, that's when there's just a ton of ads. So I'm not sure why. So that's the green digi. Awkward looking pieces, but they're all right. I gotta do the bird's nest, so I'm gonna grab these guys real quick and get them in the tank. I'm trying to figure out which tank. I guess I can put them on one in with the Kessels on it. Just trying to plan it out, trying to keep everything together, but we are limited on space. But I got to get rid of these colonies so I can add another rack. So if I can get all these guys here. Uh-huh. Just toss those in there for now. All right, bird's nest. I'm only going to do a little bit of it because I want to let this grow. Since this is, this is the only colony I've left. Sell a ton of this stuff, and then I actually end up I didn't throw a couple colonies out. The Hydrophora fell onto a big colony like this big and just melted half of it away. So yeah, running out of room. So that was part of the reason why I'm doing this. So I usually don't use a saw for bird's nests because you can just get in here and just do a quick little light pressure and a twist. You can knock those guys off pretty quick. Just gonna do a handful of frags. Keeled. I have like 30 in the tank right now, but the sale's going on. They're only 10 bucks, so people are knocking. I think I got 20 orders so far from the sale this afternoon, so it's moving. All right, so I'll leave about that much. Knock this guy out. So on other things, any of you guys play WoW? The new Shadowlands, all that stuff that's coming out soon. Let me scroll here. Let me see if it's showing up on the computer. Yeah, those questions that you guys have going on over there are not even showing up over here. That's some bullshit, and I can't even see from there. Yeah. Let's scroll up. For how long can the coral stay out of the tank? Well, it depends on the coral. SPS is usually good 15, 20 minutes. But yeah, you don't want to sit them out too long. You can't really hear the music. All right, cool. But yeah, if you can't really hear it, doesn't matter. They're still going to slam me with those monetization stuff. Hey, Travis, I switched over Red Sea Pro, and I see the alkalinity is higher than most recommendations. Mine is at 10.5. What's your opinion on and their belief of run high alk? Well, I don't know why. I mean, they have a higher alkalinity in the box for the same reason that Fritz has the red box. It's because for those of you who don't want to dose, you can use these higher alkalinity boxes and do less water changes or smaller water changes. This is a really good song too. I love this. You guys know I love this channel, Breaking Benjamin. Anyway, so you can do smaller water changes with the higher alk, and it kind of supplements the two-part dosing. So that's why people like the higher alkalinity boxes. But if you're dosing, if you're dosing, you don't need the higher alkalinity box. You just don't need it. You can just keep things stable with that your two-part or calcium rack or calc wash or whatever. But for those of you who are not wanting to dose that stuff, using the higher alkalinity boxes will make up for it. But understand that, you know, you're sitting at 7 and you're adding a 10.5 DKH box of salt, you better do a small water change so you don't get a huge jump in alkalinity. So that's my concern with that. I always recommend people just dose. It's better to have more control over your system than less. And I feel better about it. But to each his own, whatever works for you. Let me see what else we got here. More big frags looking good. Yeah, everything in the system is growing really well. Just the tank is happy. It's doing really good. This time of year is kind of, it's weird. It's like I have so much to do, but I mean, there's orders coming in, but there's not as many as we usually are. So I figure, well, I might as well stop doing this and doing this and doing this and just focus on getting stuff like this done. So it's just a weird time of the year. Summer is always weird for selling coral and all that kind of stuff. It's just weird. But it's not a bad thing. It's definitely a good time to get other things done. And that's exactly why I'm doing this right now, because I've been waiting to get these colonies out of the tank for some time now. And I will be shipping tomorrow, but whenever I'm done shipping tomorrow, I'm going to come back and finish off the rest of the colonies. So it's just nice to get it done. This is not going to stay, so I'm going to have to hold it while I give it a quick spray. All right. But yeah, summer is always interesting. All right, let me click on this. Can I get the questions? Let me scroll up. No Call of Duty on the box, yeah. Let me see what we got here. Have you tried the new bioreactors? They are no instructions and has me scratching my head on how to externally pump it. The bioreactors, you're talking about biopellet reactors? Have I used them? I don't know. I mean, I've used biopellet reactors, but a bioreactor, I don't know if that's something different. I've never used it. No directions. Hey, if you buy something and it doesn't have a YouTube video or directions with it, send that shit back. Don't even waste your time. Because if people are making products and they don't have the time to give you full instructions on how to use it and or show you in a video, they can pound sand, man. Nope. That's called, let me just make this as quickly as I can, make money on it, and see if people figure it out. That's what that's called. Let me see over here. Do you make your own frag racks, or do you still buy them? I make my own. Hey, Travis, how's it going? I love the bird's nest. Have you tried The HANA nitrate tester, thanks. I have not tried it, have not even looked at it. Something I might consider in the future. Of course, I got to make a HANA holder for it at some point. So, yeah, it's on the list of things to do and to get. But, yeah, let me know. How's it working out for you? I know it'd be nice to get a quick reading on nitrates, an accurate reading too. But, yeah, let me go and put these back. All right, I'm gonna put this colony back. But yeah, so if you guys have used the new checker, let me know how it turned out. I haven't watched any videos on it. I don't even know how it works. I just was looking at a BRS a while back, and it said that it was coming soon or something like that. So that's the extent of my knowledge. It's really weird. I had several companies reach out to me the last few days for sponsorship stuff. Kind of strange. I'm trying to figure out where that came from. But I declined because I don't want to feel pressured to do certain things. I don't want somebody to pay me and then feel pressured to have to do things a certain way. Not a fan of that. So I am going to make little bitty frags out of these. Possibly. I mean, they're pretty small. They'll grow in eventually. Almost feel like I'm wasting a plug on them, but not really. Waste none. All right, so let me go find another colony. So I think I'm gonna knock off the rest of this Birds of Paradise, and I'm gonna put a frag in the 40 gallon. I don't see one. And then let that grow a little bit and just knock that off, be done with it. It's on there pretty good. I'm gonna squeeze and it's gonna shatter. There we go. Get that out of the way. All right, so we're gonna save this frag for the 40 gallon. We'll just toss this in here. Oh, come on out and say hi, Mr. Crab. This guy's a jerk. He's in there. Come on out. This guy was back in the 125, and he used to attack my fish. But he doesn't do it anymore, but he thinks he's tough. Come on out, dude. I bet you can't guess where he got this shell from. Little jerk. I'm wiping out all my snails still in their shells. So his big ass can fit in there. Free at last. All right, so I'm going to throw this in here just for right now, and then I'll come back and glue it later. So we have a frag of that in the tank there. I'm going to cut these up on the saw. 85 people watching me make a mess. That's pretty sweet. All right. Let me check the comments here. Oops. Let me scroll back up there. All right. What's your take on calc versus two-part? Running one or the other, or even both in conjunction? Just do one or the other. Two parts easier to control. It's not based off of your evaporation, but then again, you can always run a calc reactor and dose what you want. But two parts is easier for beginners. Be right back. I'm going over your webpage. Cool. Thanks, man. Let's see here. Let me go and scroll down. What would you suggest for a Coral QT setup? Check out my Coral QT video. In the description of any coral on my website, you can see how I set up a coral QT. James BioCube is perfect. Send in sponsorships my way. Send the sponsorships my way. Yeah, I didn't know you did that, Gabe. Sponsorships are cool to a certain extent, but what's funny is the sponsorships that left me to go with somebody else and then that person turned out to be a shitbag, and then they're coming back. So, yeah, you can pound sand, bro. Yeah, moving you guys around. You will have that. Let's check the comments. Oof, that went all the way down. Same problem, different device. What spray are you using? I am using Instant Set from BRS. How would you start your bit? How did you start your business? I got a little frag tank. YouTube is how I started it. Let me put these in the tank because they've been out for a minute. But yeah, YouTube's a pretty big part of the business. Hence the reason why I still upload content. if it wasn't for the business, I probably wouldn't be uploading content based on how much I've been getting reamed lately, to be honest. But it does play a pretty big role in sales and the business, and it does give me something to look forward to every day. I like making content. You guys know that I've kind of slowed down. I don't know how long that's going to last for. I guess it depends on how long YouTube feels like bending me over, but I don't foresee that stopping anytime soon. But yeah, so I really do enjoy making content. I like it. I mean, obviously there's what 670 some on damn videos, something like that, on the channel in 4 years. So yeah, I like making content. But yeah, so the video tomorrow is going to be that whole, is there such thing as an ugly face? Because I have people debating me over this, and in the comment section saying that you have to have an ugly face, you have to go through algae and all sorts of shit. That's funny, because I haven't seen any algae in the 300. Someone's at my door. Let me go see who that is. Right back. Back. Ah, sorry about that. Had to get that taken care of. All right. What app do you, what editing app do you use for YouTube videos? I don't use an app. I use a program called Camtasia, and you have to pay for it. But we're gonna do this for a few more minutes because I gotta take care of the package that just came. Because it is live, and to make sure that it stays alive. So, but let me see what else I have to cut up. We got a few more Freya plugs. I think I'm gonna do a little bit of the Setosa, and then we'll be good for the night. I definitely gotta cut this on the saw. Then I'll have to save the rest for tomorrow. Let's see what other questions we have here. Good? You guys see? Can you guys? Good, good. Okay, yeah, the app just booted me for no reason. It's just like, hey, see you later. So, all right, cool. All right, well. Welcome back, everybody. Yeah, it was just like, see you later. I'm like, all right. I don't know what I just touched, but maybe it timed out. I don't know. Anyway. So that does not look pretty, but it will heal up pretty quickly. And let me just see what I can get from these chunks here. Yeah, Setosa is just one of those that I just let, it always cuts weird because this is the way it grows, but I always just let it heal for an extended period of time. It just seems to work out that way. Put a little bit more glue. Some toilet paper commercial. That's weird. Yeah, Charmin, thanks. All right, so we've got a couple more frags, and then we're going to be good. I appreciate everybody being here for this somewhat entertaining video, but I figure I'd bring you along for it. And yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and throw these in the frag tank, and tomorrow I'm going to cut up the rest of the frags. I don't know if I'll go live since I will be uploading a video tomorrow, but let me... Yeah, the same questions are coming through. It's really weird, but... All right, guys, so that's about it. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Wish it was a little bit more exciting, but just cutting coral and answering some basic questions. So anyway, I will see you guys tomorrow with the new video and definitely the new live stream time on Friday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're going to keep that. Seemed to work out pretty good last week. So, yeah, I'll see you guys later. All right, peace.